From the very beginning of planning all the way up to launch, we're there. We're actually one of the only groups on lab to be a part of a mission from start to end. We are the intersection of engineering and biology. We are Planetary Protection. So our group is focused on making sure we meet NASA's stringent requirements for preventing forward and backward contamination. We make sure that we don't contaminate other planetary bodies with Earth microbes before we have the chance to even study it. So we're making investments in cutting-edge technology that can enable scientific discovery and keep Earth safe.
When we start a mission, the first question we ask ourselves is, how can we protect the target body? And the way we go about doing this is really changing right now. As we think about going to exciting places like Europa and Enceladus and the other icy satellites that we might visit that have water, and we've been developing our ability to look at the probability of contamination, we know exists in spacecraft assembly areas, and that biology that then can get on spacecraft hardware and actually travel out into the solar system. And so what we're doing there is we're trying to minimize that probability of delivering one or more viable organisms to the surface of one of these icy bodies that has underneath it a big ocean of water that has all kinds of unknown chemistry that might serve as a really good place for Earth organisms to grow.
We then make sure that we microbially reduce and keep the hardware clean that we're building. This can be done by elevating the temperature and killing the microbes on the surface, by wiping it with IPA, isopropyl alcohol, and we use all kinds of new cutting-edge technologies to really help us keep it clean. When we take samples from the spacecraft, it doesn't matter if the part is small or large, it's all equally important. Once we have those samples, we then bring it to the lab and really assess how many microbes are on the surface.
Once we've sampled the spacecraft, occasionally we find microorganisms that are growing in our bioassay plates. When that happens, we bring those petri dishes up to our laboratory here, where we preserve them for future studies, investigations, and identify them. And the identifications are very important for contributing to a passenger list that might be on their way to other planetary bodies.
We can then use the DNA extracted from the clean room, as well as from the spacecraft hardware itself, to identify what kind of microbes are present on the hardware. This approach was enabled by bioinformatics, a computational modeling algorithms used to analyze the DNA sequencing data. Scientists are not only understanding microbes present in the clean room and hardware, they're also looking at microbial diversity on International Space Station. By understanding the microbial diversity, we will be equipped for human habitation or other planetary bodies in future, such as Mars.
So what do we do at the end of a mission? After we've launched, a spacecraft's on its way. We go again. We start again with the planning process on the next mission. And we work the same problems with new knowledge from the previous mission. And we put it all together to further minimize the probability of contamination and better protect the planetary bodies that we're visiting and our science integrity. We go again.
Let's go again.